What's good, YouTubers and YouTubettes? This is JB Sports back again with another one. Timmy Bradley's going in on Errol Spence for ducking Terrence Crawford. He did an interview on Fight Hype with Rahman McBerry, and he said that he's pissed off, man. He's saying that the fight can happen, man, but he said the holdup is Errol Spence. He said he's holding it up, man. The fight can easily be made. He cites that Tyson Fury and Deontay Wilder is going to fight, and they're both, you know, quote-unquote, on different sides of the street, and he's saying the same thing can happen for Terrence Crawford versus Errol Spence. He said he don't think the fight's going to happen at all. He basically saying after Errol fights Porter, that he's probably going to fight Garcia or Manny Pacquiao next and then fight somebody else after that and never will fight Terrence Crawford, man. He goes in on him. He's real pissed off, man. But, you know, I don't want to, you know, go off too bad on Timothy Bradley, man, but, you know, when he was, quote-unquote, on different side of the street than PBC fighters, you didn't never see him in the ring with a Sean Porter, which he could have fought. Andre Berto, he never fought him. He never fought Keith Thurman, who was a fighter that was getting recognition back when Bradley was fighting. He never tried to fight any of those guys. You know, he basically fought Manny Pacquiao 3 times, and then he fought Jesse Vargas. You know, he never tried to fight any of those guys. You never seen him try to fight. Him and Adrian Broner was going back and forth at a time, but that fight never materialized. So for him to sit up there and try to go in on Errol Spence and say Errol Spence has not said anything about wanting to fight Terrence Crawford, he needs to go back to the press conference for Errol Spence versus Sean Porter. Errol Spence said the roadmap that he was going to take in that on that press conference. He said he's going to fight Sean Porter, beat him, then he said he wanted the Pacquiao Thurman winner, which when the press conference that took place, that fight had not happened yet. As we know, Pacquiao won that fight, so he won Pacquiao after that. And then he say once he take care of that, then he say he want to fight Terrence Crawford next year, 2020. He said that in the press conference. So for Tim Bradley to go try to go in on Errol Spence saying he's quiet as a church mouse, basically ain't saying nothing, and Terrence Crawford is on video every day saying, oh, I want to fight Spence, I want to fight Spence, I want to fight Spence. You know, saying it to the saying it at the top of his lung every day, saying that that's not the case. Everybody knows that Terrence Crawford is soft spoken, mild mannered, and you know when everybody was first calling for this fight. Let's go back to when this thing first started jumping off about these two guys fighting. When the first jump off happened, Terrence Crawford was quiet. They tried to get him after he beat Jose Benavidez, the post fight interview in the ring. They asked him specifically about Errol Spence, and he was like, you know who I want. You don't want to, I'm not going to have to, I don't want to say it. I don't have to come out and say it. You know, he was all soft-spoken. Instead of saying Errol Spence, he should have looked in the camera and say, Errol Spence, I want you next. Let's get it on. We're the two baddest guys at 147. Let's get it on. Let's get it on. Like Marvin Gaye say, let's get it on. Yeah. Let's get it on. He should have been saying that in the ring. You feel me? He should have been saying that in the ring. And he didn't say that. Later on, as the months went on, then he started, you know, saying, yeah, I want to fight, I want to fight, I want to fight. After BOMAC, his trainer actually was the most boisterous of the thing. He was saying it from the get-go that, yeah, we want Spence. We'll destroy Errol Spence, man. We're gonna tell him a new asshole. That's basically what he said. We're gonna tell him a new asshole. You know, BOMAC was your trainer, was the one that was bumping his gun. Mo, you was like, well, you know, I ain't got to call nobody out. I'm the champion and stuff like that. You know, they know who I want, this and that. Instead of calling the man out and being boisterous, your trainer was more boisterous. But here come lately, now that Terrence Crawford sees that, you know, he really don't have a lot of appealing options on his side of the street, quote unquote, on his side of the street. He's looking at a fight against Edis Kavalauskas, a fight that nobody cares and nobody asking for. You know, he's going to have to fight him, but that's his mandatory. You got to do what you got to do and get that out the way. But he's looking on this side of the street. He got Luis Collazo, you know, probably next after that. He doesn't have a lot of appealing options. So I understand him wanting to fight Errol Spence, which is the other guy that's the top dog at 147, and he wants a big fight against him. And, you know, he wants to prove that he's the best at 147. But you got to understand that Errol Spence got, you know, he got more options. He got more appealing options. He got more options where he can make lucrative money. As you can see, the fight with Sean Porter is on pay-per-view. You know, what fight Terrence Crawford can have on his side of the street outside of Errol Spence, that's a pay-per-view fight. We all know Kavalauskas is not a pay-per-view fight. Luis Collazo is not a pay-per-view fight. So he doesn't have a lot of appealing options. So let Errol Spence take care of his side of the street. It's not like he's fighting bums. It'd be one thing if he was fighting you know, guys, you know, be one thing, he fight Victor Ortiz and Jose Cito Lopez and stuff like that, you know, and not fighting Terrence Crawford, but he's fighting quality people. He just got through fighting Mikey Garcia, who was a top five, who was in everybody's top five pound for pound, even though he moved up two weight classes, act like that was some kind of miracle that somebody actually moved up two weight classes. You heard of Sugar Shane Mosley? He moved up two weight classes, became champion at 147. You heard of Roberto Duran? Roberto Duran went from lightweight to welterweight, beat Sugar Ray Leonard. So that's don't act like what he did was like, oh man, he fought some other guy. He came up two weight classes, like something we ain't never seen in boxing. We seen that in boxing before. So let's get that out the way. He beat Mikey Garcia. Now he's fighting Sean Porter, arguably the number three welterweight in the division behind him and Terrence Crawford. So it's not like he's fighting another guy. If he wins that, he's fighting, he's going to try to get a fight with Manny Pacquiao, which is a lucrative fight, which is more money on the table for a Manny Pacquiao fight than a Terrence Crawford fight. I love Terrence Crawford, great fighter, number one on my pound for pound list. So don't get it twisted thinking I'm hating on Terrence Crawford. He's a great fighter. I'm talking about money. I'm talking about moolah. Dollars. If it ain't making dollars, it ain't making sense. And he makes more money fighting Manny Pacquiao than he does Terrence Crawford. And arguably, Manny Pacquiao has a case that he's the number one welterweight in the division based on who he's beating. He just beat the undefeated champion. Who else beat them? He can make a case to them. You know, I put him number four, you know, behind Terrence, Errol Spence, and Sean Porter. I put Manny Pacquiao number four, but he's got a case to be number one. So he fight him next. You can't argue that. And now once he takes care of that, then I think he should fight Terrence Crawford next after that, sometime in 2020, just like he stated in the press conference. Now, if he don't fight Terrence Crawford after he defeats Manny Pacquiao, if he gets that fight, that's a big deal. You know, I don't know if he gets that fight, but if he gets that fight and he beats him, and if he fights somebody like a Ugas or somebody after that and don't fight Terrence Crawford, then we got a different discussion. Then we got a different argument. You see me? You feel me? We got a different argument. But right now, you can't knock what Errol Spence trying to do. He's fighting the top dogs at the welterweight division, you know, and that's what it is. And another thing Terrence Crawford going to have to understand is he's not going to get 50-50. This is not a 50-50 fight. This man doing pay-per-view, his pay-per-view numbers did better than your pay-per-view. Let's look at what you did with Amir Khan, what your pay-per-view vibes was with Amir Khan, and let's look what Errol Spence's pay-per-view vibes was with Mikey Garcia. People going to be like, oh, man, that was Mikey Garcia fan. The fight was in Errol Spence's hometown. How you just going to take that away from him? Errol's from Dallas. It ain't like they fought in L.A. He fought in Dallas, 47,000 fans out there. You know, of course, Mikey Garcia had some fans, but Errol Spence had a lot of fans, too. And then pay-per-view is everywhere. That's not just, it's all over the U.S. That's U.S. pay-per-view. That's not Dallas, Texas pay-per-view. That's not Los Angeles pay-per-view. That's pay-per-views everywhere. And it did almost 400,000 pay-per-views. So he had a very successful pay-per-views. And the same people that could bought pay-per-views for Errol Spence and Mikey Garcia could have bought the pay-per-view for Amir Khan and Terrence Crawford, and evidently they didn't do it to them numbers that they did with Errol. You know, he did what, 150,000 pay-per-views? That's what some reported. 150,000 pay-per-views. Okay then. So Tim Bradley need to fall back, check the facts, know what he's talking about, and quit bumping those gums. Because, you know, I know you're looking out for your boy. You know, he's one of your sparring partners when you were getting ready for Pacquiao, and y'all got a good friendship, good history. I understand all that. But check your facts, man, and get your facts together, man. You're bumping your gums, and a lot of stuff you're saying, it's not accurate. Just bottom line, it's not accurate. You're trying to hate on this man, Errol Spence, and then we look back on your career, you wasn't trying to fight none of them PBC fighters, your own damn self, and you're trying to call out Errol Spence, and he's fighting top dogs at 147, and he stated in the press conference that he's going to fight Sean Porter, I mean, he's going to fight Terrence Crawford 2020. Let him get his business taken care of on his side of the street in his own pop in 2020 with Terrence Crawford. He told you guys that. Be patient. Fight Edis Colascas. Maybe fight Luis Collazo after that. And then get ready for Errol Spence 2020. But best believe it, it ain't going to be 50-50. You know, if he gives you 60-40, you need to take that and run with it. Terrence Crawford. That's what I advise you and Bob Arum to do. If Errol Spence gives you 60-40, you better take it and run with it. That's about the best you're going to get. It could be lower than that based on the numbers that each fighter bringing to the table. But if you get 60-40, you better take it and run with it. That's just what it is. This is JB Sports, the man, the myth, the legend. I holla.